Black Panther was one of the successful movies of this past year. By shedding light on the Kingdom of Wakanda, it has not only created a new avenue within the Marvel Cinematic Universe, but also provided us fans with jaw-dropping visuals and characters. One of the most intriguing characters, however, is M'Baku. As the leader of the Jabari tribe, he plays a pivotal role in this movie as well as in the comics. Fans in India and elsewhere couldn't help but notice a surprise that the filmmakers had in store. Just before the fight for the throne against T'Challa, M'Baku praises the deity of the Jabari tribe.
Glory to Hanuman.
Yes, you heard that right. He proclaims glory to Hanuman. Within the movie there has been a few changes, like changing the name of the leader of the Jabari tribe, from the often used moniker, the Man-Ape, to calling him by his real name, M'Baku. Was the reference to Hanuman similar, or did it have any other, deeper meaning? Let's find out in this episode of Trivial Cinema. The Gorilla God. The Wakandan religion incorporates stories about the extra-dimensional gods, known as the Heliopolitans, and as the Ennead. In particular, the god most associated with Wakanda, the Panther God, has been established as being the feline Ennead past. Another major Wakandan god is the Gorilla God. Though some have speculated that it might be Thoth, who does have an ape form, the gorilla might not be of the Ennead. In the comics, Kekre, the ape god, is the central figure of the White Gorilla cult, a religion banished from the Wakandan society, but still practiced among the Jabari, led by M'Baku. From context, one gets the impression that the gorilla god is native to Wakanda, whereas the panther god, Bast, is an import from the north. There is another theory to it. In this, Hanuman is a gorilla god, worshipped by the Jabari. In the Jabari law, Hanuman donated to his followers a sacred tree. This provided them with an exceptionally strong wood, which they used to build their weapons and their city. After separating themselves from the main Wakandan civilization, the Jabari continued to worship Hanuman instead of the panther god Bast. Masks and statue of Hanuman were constructed everywhere in Jabari territory. Before the ritual combat against Prince T'Challa, M'Baku wore a gorilla mask and praised the superiority of his god over Bast. Now let us look at some other theories, which might provide a possible explanation. Marvel has borrowed mythological elements from all over the world, like Norse, Egyptian, and the larger Indic culture. In fact, Hanuman is not the only part of Black Panther, influenced by the Indian culture, as the movie also features the lotus meditative position. Hanuman replaces Kekre. Another reason for why Marvel showed Hanuman instead of Kekre could be because, if they showed Kekre and the white gorillas, then they would have to show some backstory, which would make the movie lengthy and overstuffed. So, they could have chosen an already popular god who has a relatable personality, Hanuman. As an art and pop culture icon, Hanuman happens to be well known outside India. Another theory states that Black Panther carries the burden of history on its shoulder and is steeped in symbolism. Jabari tribe worshipping Hanuman is a subtle hat tip to African pride movement, which is not afraid to re-embrace their roots, despite the colonial stigmatization. The African population gradually found their cultural ties with ape gods, fading in the process of subjugation and colonization. An animal which once was celebrated, now became symbolic of shame. But the Jabari, on the other hand, are an isolated tribe. They shun the new ways, including vibranium. Due to their lack of interaction with Western world and the westernized perspective, their faith and its expression remains intact. Hence it is only natural that they worship and celebrate the ape god for his strength and virility. Their worship symbolizes fearless expression of African identity, which doesn't give a damn about what outsiders think of them. and finally, a theory which might be the closest to the truth. The Indian audience. India has the largest youth population in the world, and a huge Marvel fan base. One thing is very common among Indians, that we love any praise that comes our way from foreigners, although this wasn't the case in earlier times. The success of vloggers, who make Bollywood-related reaction videos, is a good example of it. As Disney is planning to expand its business in India, this may be a marketing strategy for them. But, if this was the case however, we should consider the fact that, right before the film's release in India, the filmmakers removed all references to Hanuman, voluntarily. What do you think might be the reason? Provide your thoughts and feedback in the comments section. Also, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Trivial Cinema. Until next time, thanks for watching.